Remain vigilant.
Nene need more! More! Aho! Aho!
Thank you.
Greetings. We have heard from Teelan that a man called Radzim lives within these walls.
Ah, friends of Teelan's, are you? We've been expecting you. Go on, in you get.
You're letting us straight through.
You don't look particularly concerning, is all. These walls are imposing, but they aren't here for controlling foot traffic. They're to keep savage monsters from having themselves a rampage.
Most sensible. Well, we'll be going then.
Vikings! Sorry for time taking.
Thank you.
Hey.
Problem?
One just want nap.
Xeno, look! What splendid armor! Oh, it's true! Scales so shiny and sparkly!
It looks the same as any armor, if you ask me.
Different subtle.
Sure is.
Really?
Pardon me. Have you come from Companion's Cape, by any chance?
We've just come from the laboratory. But we were at the Cape just before that.
And was everyone there all right?
Yes, it seemed to me.
Thank goodness. That's a relief to hear.
Is something wrong?
You may be aware, but originally, we all lived here together as a group.
But then, some left because there are machina here.
Exactly. At first, we managed to tolerate each other in relative harmony. Obviously, we had our share of friction.
What happened?
Well, the final straw was something trivial. The Companions tried all sorts of ploys to retake the capital, but none of the plans succeeded. Many soldiers were lost this way. One machina had had enough and told them to just give up.
And that's when it happened?
Yeah. They shouted, "If you rust rats hadn't betrayed us, we wouldn't have lost our brethren and our homes in the first place." Things got heated, and then they left and didn't look back.
They shouldn't have forgotten that we all lost friends, family, and homes.
They're soldiers, ma'am. In the war, they put everything on the line for their country. And so,
when their country was taken from them, the extent of their anger and resentment was fully understandable.
Yes. Still, we who stayed behind don't bear them any grudges. They protected us all, for a long time, regardless of race. And bear in mind, in the end, they didn't cast the machina out. They left the safety of our walls of their own volition. That's why we pledged that if they chose to return, we'd welcome them back and meet them with a smile.
I will do whatever is in my power to make it so.
Day-day, my eyes sweating. Inflammation of tear ducts.
By the way, we have heard that someone by the name of Radzim lives here.
Radzim? Yes, he lives over there.
Over there. Thank you. Very kind.
It was Radsom, actually. He was the one who told the companions to give up their quest. Right. I see.
All right. Let's go and see him straight away.
Yes, let's.
Yes? Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hey, okay.
Are you perchance Radsom?
Yeah, that's me. How do you know my name?
Teelan mentioned you. You are his fellow researcher.
Oh, I see. Teelan sent you. Him and Tyrae are still getting on, okay?
Quite. Though she did give him a good scolding earlier.
Went to Alchemoth again, did he? I did warn him not to be reckless. But when it comes to his research, that boy has tunnel vision. To be honest, so does Tyrea.
Does she come here much as well?
No, Hardly ever. She's even more focused on the work than Teelan. I couldn't begin to guess why she's so driven.
It must be about her mother after all.
Radzim, we have questions. About the Fog King.
I see. That's why you're so curious.
We need more to go on. What can you tell us?
Because of the Telethia's ether field, the Fog King and his Fog Beasts seem, well, unable to escape Alchemoth.
Ether field?
Yeah. It's the means by which Telethia eliminate any excess ether that they absorb. Now, the Fog King and his beasts happen to give off an awful lot of ether.
I see. So all Telethia in the vicinity flock there, to feed on the ether, and, as a result, keep the threat contained.
Oh, this hot noggin of Xeno. It get worse if not shut up.
But my ether, it worked against Fog Beasts, but not the Fog King. Or rather, it didn't even seem to make direct contact with him.
Shulk, Melia? Would you do me a favor and head to Teelan's lab, borrow his Telethia research notes for me?
Sure, we can do that for you.
There's something I'd like to look up about the Telethia's ether field.
Understood.
On another note, we heard that you spoke out against the Companions.
I voiced an opinion, yes. I can understand their impatience. Their ancestral home was right there. However, I couldn't abide watching them throw away more lives for nothing.
Nothing. Sounds quite stark.
At first, there were hundreds of us living here. But now? Well, you've seen for yourselves.
And all because of the Fog King.
Yeah. So I think you can see why I said what I said. If we end up extinct, we'll have won nothing.
Well spoken. But I'm sure the Companions would find those words hard to swallow. I'm sorry. Your people are no more free to go home than we are.
No need for you to apologize, Melia. In truth, it's not costing me any sleep. They seem to be catching on too. After all, they've stayed put since then.
When you put it like that, the people of Grandel, they're living under considerable strain, not knowing what became of their homes, and with no means of return.
Hmm. But that's also true of Maxis. His people lost their homes too.
Yes. But they're feeling desperate, and it's making them unreasonable.
It too sad.
We were like that too once, weren't we?
Yes, we were.
Is that true?
Hmm. But we learned, eventually. All because we wanted to protect the world. And we made that dream a reality. We brought down Zanza.
Overcoming our prejudice gave us strength in unity. Because we shared a goal.
Radzim's folk, the Companions, and us as well. We all share the same goal.
Defeating the Fog King and returning home.
Hmm.
Sounds like job for Hero Blanquino. Just let Nene at him.
Thank you, everyone.
Mamma mia, what that thing?
Is that?
It's like the one we saw in Alchemoth, but much, much larger.
You're right.
Shulk, let's see if we can get closer.
Yeah.
What is it?
Thank you.
What is happening over there?
Beasts were meant to be confined within Alchemoth.
I don't think that's where those ones came from.
What do you mean?
The rift made normal monsters transform into fog beasts.
Grandel!
Ah!
What is matter?
The Armus could turn into fog beasts.
Meh, meh! No one to picture that! Must hurry to rescue!
Instinct was right, Melia.
Yes, although the rift's influence is spreading far too quickly. Radson, are you fine?
Miss Melia, these armors, it was so sudden.
You can explain later. Let us do the fighting here. You should seek refuge.
Right you are. Thank you for that.
Was everyone all right?
Yeah. No major injuries to speak of. All thanks to you, of course.
Xeno accepts year's supply of sweet wasabi as reward.
Real Hereupon never has compensation.
Where it say that?
Shulk, was it the Rift's expanding influence that's responsible for our Armu's transformation?
Looks like it. We saw it happen before, too. Regular monsters turned into fog beasts, just like that.
That suggests more fog beasts will appear if the Rift continues to spread its vileness. Consider, with the size it was before, the Rift's effect was limited to the area within the capital. But now it's getting wider.
One moment. In that case, if the Rift keeps growing larger...
All monsters everywhere could be changed by the fog.
We must find a way to fight back.
We'll need those research notes for that. Let's head for the lab.
Right.
Villain! What do you want?
You stand in the way of a new age dawning.
Sis, I'm scared.
It's all right. I'll protect you, and I'll work, I swear.
Behold, the widening rift in the sky. It's proof definite the world abhors you.
Spare me your ravings.
Oh, Lady Melia, the hope of our race.
GaelGar, what is this treachery?
As you can see, I am sweeping away some pebbles. Their research is blasphemy against the commingled blood.
Don't you comprehend the import of what you're interrupting? The very future of our race hinges on their work.
You think this is the future? This reactionary struggle to revive what is long buried? The future of the Hyentia is us. We are what the race ought to become. We are the true face of the Hyentia.
If not for our ancestors, we would never even have drawn breath.
Ancestors? I recognize them not. You, Lady Melia, are our progenitor. You were our beginning, and you will be our future.
Senseless drivel. If you would interfere with this research for the sake of spouting your nonsense, you do not deserve my mercy!
Melia!
Why won't you understand? Why won't you accept that we are the ones destined to lead?
You will not so easily refute our history!
So be it! I reject you! I will take the mantle and become father of our kin! I will take dominion over all, and the world will be set to rights!
I'm feeling
make me laugh! Your blood's not what they deserve!
We can definitely do this!
No, no, let us your power!
You think you know my mind?
You know that!
This isn't going well.
Dying words will be poetry to my ears! scratch.
Gone. Here goes!
Back
to
away!
Look at
this guy! Nary scratch.
Ready to table.
How can this be?
You can definitely do this.
You
almost got what they deserve.
How can this be?
Nary scratch.
How is that possible?
Hurry up!
Impossible.
Nary scratch.
You can do it.
I know I am not wrong. I'm not.
I will spare you. Just be gone from my sight.
No! The lab!
Melia!
Miss Melia!
No! Idiot!
The crown is mine now.
Talon!
Vixis, help!
Better safe than sorry. The pure blood meets its end today.
Are you okay, Talon?
Talethia, here! Damn! She's okay. She's all right.
I'm sorry. I couldn't save. The future.
House. The lab went up in flames, so we carried you here.
The lab? I'm sorry, Talon. I failed you.
Miss Melia?
You damn fool! What possessed you to do that? What happened to safeguarding the future of the Hyentia? And bringing our brethren back home, were those just words to you? You should think long and hard about what the death of a leader would mean for us.
Come on, big sis. That's enough.
Don't defend her. This idiot child.
I had to.
What?
To protect it at all cost. The research.
How can you be so fixated on that?
Our salvation lies therein. I believe it now.
Melia.
And yet, ultimately it was for naught. I caused trouble for everyone. And I couldn't even save the documents.
Poor Miss Melly.
That's not true. If you and your friends hadn't come when you did, there might not have been anything left of the research to continue with. And also... here.
What's this?
It's the book you carried out of the fire. Ring any bells?
This tome. We found it in the tomb.
Yeah. The book that started my research. If we have this, me and Tyrea can carry on with our work. Sis, are you with me?
Yes, right. We can study the problem until we make some headway.
Miss Melia, thank you.
Likewise.
Teelan. Tyrea.
You've only just woken up. Come on, we'll let you rest.
Yes. Thank you.
What that for?
Xeno used tranquil snooze for C-suite dreams.
That seems extremely excessive.
This might just be what we need to defeat the Fog King.
Yeah.
Feeling better?
Yes. Much better now.
What a relief.
Miss Melly, good as new. Xeno saved day again. Less braggy, please.
Friends, I'm sorry I worried you. And I abused your hospitality. Please forgive me.
No. You saved this place and we owe you, big time. This was the least I could do.
I will not stop now. I swear to do what I can for the good of Grandel.
I appreciate it. Just don't go running yourself ragged for us.
I promise. We seem to be missing Tyrea.
Oh, if you're looking for her, she figured the fog beasts might strike again, so she went out on patrol.
The likes of us aren't exactly trained for battle. So, really, any help is welcome.
You're right. I feel sorry for any beasts that wander into Tyrea's path.
Huh.
By the way, did I hear you mention something about defeating the Fog King?
All thanks to our friend's research.
Is that so?
Quite.
A sterling achievement, Teelan.
Just an accident.
Still, even so, your devotion to your mother may well have saved our future. All right. What do we have to do? How do we defeat the Fog King?
We found ether attacks effective against fog beasts. But not against the Fog King. That's because the ether's concentration was too low.
Concentration?
Concentration? Pipe down when adults talking, dum-dum.
But Xeno's so bored!
The whole thing got me wondering. Why did fog beasts appear when the rift got wider? I think the intensity of the rift's rays exceeded the density of the Telethia's ether field.
None of that makes any sense to me. How is the density connected to the Fog King?
If we could put up an ether field denser than the Telethia's, the Fog King will become vulnerable.
How does one put up an ether field? Secondly, where does one obtain such highly concentrated ether?
For the field, I think this guy will do the job, with a little tinkering.
In that case, it's just a matter of gathering up enough high-purity ether crystals, except...
Except what?
Those kinds of ether crystals are extremely rare. I'm not sure where I'd even start looking. There might be none at all around here.
Oh, cheer up, all of you. It is not a foregone conclusion. And in any scenario, if we cannot defeat the Fog King without them, we will have to keep looking until we find them.
Hmm. True enough.
Good. Then let us start by asking around.
Hey!
A-okay.
Thank you.
What's up?
Are you that?
Something on your mind?
Ah! Ha! Summon! Ain't a starting
enemy fair and square.
No enemy can stand against us when we bring our might to bear.
That's because you're both pretty sturdily built.
Huh?
Yeah?
Huh? Why the cold stairs? Wait, is there an enemy behind me?
All right.
Definitely do this!
Nene, hang free! Back home!
fine.
I have become stronger.
I'm feeling it.
A magnificent strike, Nene.
You're fearless, Nene.
Feel ecstatic to get toasty.
Let us hurry onwards.
Be reckless.
Let us remain vigilant.
That feel like run a pollen mill.
Because you're both pretty sturdily built.
Huh?
Huh? Why the cold stairs? Wait, is there an enemy behind me?
Nanona? Brave mortal!
Upon the third through naming.
It's over.
Did Nene knock off socks?
But we cannot be reckless. Stronger.